hands wrapped around my finger, and it's so quiet in the world tonight. Your little eyelids flutter 'cause you're dreaming, so I tuck you in, turn on your favorite nightlight. To you, everything's funny. You got nothing to regret. I'd give all I have, honey, if you could stay like that. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. It could stay this simple. I won't let nobody hurt you. Won't let no one break your heart. No, no one will desert you. Just try to never grow up. Never grow up. You're in the car on the way to the movies, and you're mortified your mom's dropping you off. At 14, there's just so much you can't do, and you can't wait to move out someday and call your own shots. But don't make her drop you off around the block. Remember that she's getting older too. And don't lose the way that you dance around in your PJs getting ready for school. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. It could stay this simple. And no one's ever burned you. Nothing's ever left you scarred. And even though you want to, just try to never grow up. Take pictures in your mind of your childhood room. Memorize what it sounded like when your dad gets home. Remember the footsteps, remember the words said, and know your little brother's favorite songs. I just realized everything I have is someday gonna be gone. So here I am in my new apartment in a big city. They just dropped me off. It's so much colder than I thought it would be, so I tuck myself in and turn my nightlight on. Wish I'd never grown up. I wish I'd never grown up. Wish I'd never grown up, could still be little. Oh, I don't wanna grow up. Wish I'd never grown up, it could still be simple. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. You just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Could stay this simple. Hurt you, won't let no one break your heart. And even though you want to, please try to never go. Oh, 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 oh. Don't you ever go. Oh, oh, oh. Never go.
Just never go.
Sun is down, freezing cold. That's how we already know when it's here. My dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him. Yeah, I tried to show him. Yeah, 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 yeah. Gone on you with the pick and roll. Younger flame, he in sickle mode.
What is your favorite memory?
So me and Lily are captains of the Hershey Color Guard here at Hershey High School. And my favorite memory is having fun at the football games and seeing the student section get so excited. Yeah, and my favorite memory would have to be meeting all the underclassmen and theme days at band camp and all the memories that we made there along the way.
One thing that I really loved about high school was spending time with my friends and going on field trips.
Describe your time in high school.
I would have to say my time in high school was eventful.
Yeah, I believe my time in high school was comical.
My favorite memory from high school is probably creating a book of Mr. Bitt's quotes sophomore year of high school.
All of the extracurricular meetings, Model UN, Youth and Government Speech and Debate, a lot of bonding time, a lot of lifelong friends that I made in those clubs, definitely really made my high school experience.
Probably performing with musicals.
Living a good life full of goodbyes. My eyes are on the gray sky, saying I don't want to come home tonight. Yeah, and I'm higher up off wood. I don't even remember, but my friend passed out in the override. All my boys were with me going up for the night.
Wow,
but who cares? Who cares? This is all, yeah. In the spring, yeah. While I'm high off my American dream, we don't always say what we mean. It's the lie of an American dream. We don't always say what we mean when we're high off our American dream.
To the Hershey Trojan football team.
You know I'm back like I never left. Another sprint, another step, another day, another breath. Been chasing dreams, but I never slept. Then at least on life is a piece of mind. Seeking a find, I can sleep when I die. Want a piece of the pie, got the keys to the riding. I'm straight, I'm on my way. I'm on my way, get out my way. I'm running late, what can I say? I heard you die twice. Once when they bury you in the grave, and the second time is the last time that somebody mentions your name. So when I leave here on this earth, did I take more than I gave? Did I look out for the people, or did I do it all for fame? Legend is Exodus, searching for euphoria.
How are you feeling on the last day?
Amazing, actually. Did senior prank last night, this morning.
Might have gotten a little bit of trouble, but it's all right because Mishmit forgave us. Last day's a breeze. Just having fun signing yearbooks and enjoying the last couple hours with my friends.
It's just I'm getting a lot of flashbacks of all the past moments of like kindergarten through up to now.
Last day going pretty smooth. Started the morning late last night. This morning with senior prank went off pretty much without a hitch. Just went through the day, talked to my teachers, a little reminiscing. No tears yet, but good breeze day, last day with the friends.
Even the smallest interactions that we've had have made a great impact in my life in some beneficial way. Please know that I love you guys from the bottom of my heart. I will miss you guys from the bottom of my heart. And when we go our separate ways after graduation, know that no matter how far we are from each other, the distance is only going to measure the strength of our friendship.
Do you want to tell your classmates at the end of the year?
To accomplish their goals and never give up.
Period.
We're all bored. We're all so tired of everything we wait for. Trains that just aren't
perfection.
Coming. We show off.
Girl, this is going to be for the graduation.
Wait, what? Trust me, mine is better.
Woo! How are you feeling on the last day?
I am bored and have done nothing all day.
Know exactly what we're doing. We cry tears of mascara in the bathroom. Honey, life is just a classroom.
Chapter ends, a new one now begins. Time has come for letting go. The hardest part is when you know all of these years when we were here are ending, but I'll always remember we have had the time of our lives, and now the pages turn. The stories we will write. We have had the time of our lives, and I will not forget the faces left behind. It's hard to walk away from the best of days, but if it has to end, I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our lives. Where the water meets the land, shifting in the sand, like the tide that ebbs and flows. Memories will come and go, all of these years when we were here are ending, but I'll always remember. We have had the time of our lives, and now the pages turn, the stories we will write. We have had the time of our lives. The time of our lives, and I will not forget the faces left behind. It's hard to walk away from the best of days, but if it has to end, I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our lives. I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our life.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. But in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Ooh.
Astro. Yeah. Sun is down, freezing cold. That's how we already know. When it's here, my dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him. Yeah. I tried to show him. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Gone on you with the pick and roll. Younger flame, he in sicko mode.
What is your favorite memory?
So me and Lily are captains of the Hershey Color Guard here at Hershey High School. And my favorite memory is having fun at the football games and seeing the student section get so excited.
Yeah, and my favorite memory would have to be meeting all the underclassmen and theme days at band camp and all the memories that we made there along the way.
One thing that I really loved about high school was spending time with my friends and going on field trips.
Describe your time in high school.
I would have to say my time in high school was eventful.
Yeah, I believe my time in high school was comical.
My favorite memory from high school is probably creating a book of Mr. Bitt's quotes sophomore year of high school.
All of the extracurricular meetings, Mommy Win, Youth and Government Speech and Debate, a lot of bonding time, a lot of lifelong friends that I made in those clubs, definitely really made my high school experience.
Probably performing with the musicals.
Living the good life full of goodbyes. My eyes are on the gray sky, saying I don't want to come home tonight. Yeah, and I'm higher up off wood. I don't even remember, but my friend passed out in the override. All my boys were with me going up for the night.
Wow,
but who cares? Who cares? This is all, yeah. In the spring, while I'm half my American dream. We don't always say what we mean. It's the lie of an American dream. We don't always say what we mean. When we're half our American dream.
To the Hershey Trojan football team.
You know I'm back like I never left. Another sprint, another step, another day, another breath. Been chasing dreams, but I never slept. I got a new attitude that a lease on life is a peace of mind. Seeking a find, I can sleep when I die. Want a piece of the pie, got the keys to the ride. And I'm straight, I'm on my way. You died twice, once when they bury you in the grave, and the second time is the last time that somebody mentions your name. So when I leave here on this earth, did I take more than I gave? Did I look out for other people, or did I do it all for fame? Legend is Exodus, searching for euphoria, trudging through the mud to find the present, no ignoring us. Got 20,000 deep up in the street like we some warriors. My mama told me never bow your head.
Whoa. I feel good.
Through the darkest part of the night, and now I see the sunrise. Now I feel.
How are you feeling on the last day?
Amazing, actually. Did senior prank last night, this morning. Might have gotten a little bit of trouble, but it's all right because Mishmit forgave us. Last day's a breeze. Just having fun signing yearbooks and enjoying the last couple hours with my friends.
It's just I'm getting a lot of flashbacks of all the past moments of like kindergarten through up all up to now.
Last day going pretty smooth. Started the morning late last night. This morning with senior prank went off pretty much without a hitch. Just went through the day, talked to my teachers, a little reminiscing. No tears yet, but good breeze day. Last day with the friends.
Even the smallest interactions that we've had have made a great impact in my life in some beneficial way. Please know that I love you guys from the bottom of my heart. I will miss you guys from the bottom of my heart. And when we go our separate ways after graduation, know that no matter how far we are from each other, the distance is only going to measure the strength of our friendship.
Do you want to tell your classmates at the end of the year?
To accomplish your goals and never give up.
Here you
are. We're all bored. We're all so tired of everything.
How are you feeling on the last day?
I am bored and have done nothing all day.
Wrapped around my finger and it's so quiet in the world tonight. Your little eyelids flutter cause you're dreaming, so I tuck you in, turn on your favorite nightlight. To you, everything's funny. You got nothing to regret. I'd give all I have, honey, if you could stay like that. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up, don't you ever grow up, just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up, don't you ever grow up, it could stay this simple. I won't let nobody hurt you, won't let no one break your heart, no, no one will desert you. Just try to never grow up. never grow up. You're in the car on the way to the movies and you're mortified. Your mom's dropping you off. At 14, there's just so much you can't do, and you can't wait to move out someday and call your own shots. But don't make her drop you off around the block. Remember that she's getting older too. And don't lose the way that you dance around in your PJs getting ready for school. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. It could stay this simple. And no one's ever burned you. Nothing's ever left you scarred. And even though you want to, just try to never grow up. Take pictures in your mind of your childhood room. Memorize what it sounded like when your dad gets home. Remember the footsteps, remember the words said, and all your little brother's favorite songs. I just realized everything I have is someday gonna be gone. So here I am in my new apartment in a big city. They just dropped me off. It's so much colder than I thought it would be. So I tuck myself in and turn my nightlight on. Wish I'd never grown up. I wish I'd never grown up. Wish I'd never grown up, could still be little. Oh, I don't wanna grow up. Wish I'd never grown up, it could still be simple. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up, just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up, could stay this simple. You won't let no one break your heart. And even though you want to, please try to never go. Oh, 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 oh. Don't you ever go. Never go. Just never go.
Sun is down, freezing cold. That's how we already know. When it's here, my dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him. Yeah. I tried to show him. Yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Gone on you with the pick and roll. Younger flame, he in sicko mode.
What is your favorite memory?
So me and Lily are captains of the Hershey Color Guard here at Hershey High School. And my favorite memory is having fun at the football games and seeing the student section get so excited.
Yeah, and my favorite memory would have to be meeting all the underclassmen and theme days at band camp and all the memories that we made there along the way.
One thing that I really loved about high school was spending time with my friends and going on field trips.
Describe your time in high school.
I would have to say my time in high school was eventful.
Yeah, I believe my time in high school was comical.
My favorite memory from high school is probably creating a book of Mr. Bitt's quotes sophomore year of high school.
All of the extracurricular meetings, Model UN, youth and government speech and debate, a lot of bonding time, a lot of lifelong friends that I made in those clubs, definitely really made my high school experience.
Probably performing with the musicals.
Living a good life full of goodbyes. My eyes are on the gray sky, saying I don't want to come home tonight. Yeah, and I'm high up off wood. I don't even remember, but my friend passed out in the override. All my boys were with me going up for the night.
Wow,
but who cares? Who cares? This is all, yeah. Up in the spring, while I'm high off my American dream. We don't always say what we mean. It's the lie of an American dream. We don't always say what we mean. When we're high off our American dream.
To the Hershey Trojan football team.
You know I'm back like I never left. Another sprint, another step, another day, another breath. Been chasing dreams, but I never slept. Then a lease on life is a piece of mind. Seeking to find, I can sleep when I die. Want a piece of the pie, got the keys to the ride. And I'm straight, I'm on my way. I'm on my way, get out my way. I'm running late, what can I say? I heard you die twice. Once when they bury you in the grave. And the second time is the last time that somebody mentions your name. So when I leave here on this earth, did I take more than I gave? Did I look out for the people? Or did I do it all for fame? Legend is Exodus, searching for euphoria.
Feeling on the last day?
Amazing, actually. Did senior prank last night, this morning. Might have got a little bit of trouble, but it's all right because Mishmit forgave us. Last day's a breeze. Just having fun signing yearbooks and enjoying the last couple hours with my friends.
It's just I'm getting a lot of flashbacks of all the past moments of like kindergarten through up all up to now.
Last day going pretty smooth. Started the morning late last night, this morning with senior prank, went off pretty much without a hitch. Just went through the day, talked to my teachers, a little reminiscing, no tears yet, but good breeze day, last day with the friends.
Even the smallest interactions that we've had have made a great impact in my life in some beneficial way. Please know that I love you guys from the bottom of my heart. I will miss you guys from the bottom of my heart. And when we go our separate ways after graduation, know that no matter how far we are from each other, the distance is only going to measure the strength of our friendship.
Do you want to tell your classmates at the end of the year?
To accomplish their goals and never give up.
Hear ya!
We're all bored. We're all so tired of everything. We wait for trains that just aren't coming. We show off.
Girl, this is going to be so graduation.
Trust me, mine is better.
Woo! We're so young. How are you feeling on the last day?
I am bored and have done nothing all day.
Know exactly what we're doing. We cry tears of mascara in the bathroom. Honey, life is just a classroom.
Best of days.
But if it has to end, I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our lives.
Please rise for the playing of the national anthem. Please be seated. Good evening, Dr. Winslow, Ms. Schmidt, school board members, faculty, family, friends, and the reason we are all here today, good evening to the class of 2022. And welcome. And welcome to the 115th Hershey High School Commencement Ceremony. Jane Austen once said, "Let us never underestimate the power of a well-written letter." So today, I wrote what I hope is a well-written letter to my class that I want to share with you all. Dear class of 2022, what comes next? On August 27th, 2018, a little more than 300 freshmen walked timidly into Hershey High School to start what might be called the most transformative years of our lives. We thought we knew everything we needed to know. We knew who our friends were, knew who we liked, knew the workings of a Rubik's Cube, and of course, we knew how to make slime or rainbow loom bracelets. We were on top of the world and totally ready to have the awesome adventures of high school we had watched others go through in real life and on TV shows. But then our sophomore year was interrupted, and we didn't get the traditional high school experience we had all wanted and hoped for since we were little kids. August 30th, 2021, many, many classes later, a few of which were over Zoom, no longer the little kids we once were. It was our last first day of high school. We were finally back in the building, no longer able to FaceTime during math or join class while on vacation. We were in the first row in all the sports functions. We had roles in the cast of the school plays and musicals, and we were leaders of the clubs we'd been in for years. College and trade school applications started. We looked for jobs out of high school, and we made plans to travel. We were ready to graduate, so excited to be out of high school, yet still so unsure of our own futures. We would graduate, and then? Then what? The big question, what comes next? We took countless tests over the years. We turned in hundreds of assignments. We performed on the auditorium stage and on the sports stage. We marched in the band and danced with color guard. We attended club meetings and worked outside jobs. We took our younger siblings to school, and we were the younger siblings being brought to school. We fought the temptation to sleep in class, and sometimes we lost. And we cheered when a snow day was announced. We hung out with friends, we won awards, set records, and we led flash mobs. We had our high school experience, and now it's gone. Another chapter in the book of our lives vanished almost as quickly as it started. It may be hard to say goodbye, but we have to save the memories that we created and make room for the many new ones. A little-known musical artist named Taylor Swift, aka T-Swizzle, has a plethora of good songs, but in my opinion, one of the best is called Right Where You Left Me. The opening verse sings, "Friends break up, friends get married, strangers get born, strangers get buried. Trends change, rumors fly through new skies." This song is about whether we are aware of it or not. Change is prominent and will be continually abundant in our lives. In the fall, no matter where we are, our lives will not be the same as they are now. We are going our separate ways and it will not be easy. Change never is. In the last few years, we have been forced to grow up in preparation for the next phase of our lives. Starting something new will take its toll on all of us, but we are a strong class. We have not had it easy throughout our years of high school. And if anything, we have proved that in the face of adversity, we will prevail. And from this moment on, everything we know will change. As we leave the stage of our lives and start our next chapter, I think it's important to remember several things. Our environment will shape us into who we are, so we must surround ourselves with only what will help us grow. Never say no to something that's free, but be mindful about what you take. Not everyone is going to like the decisions you make, but we have to do what is best for us, and we cannot let other people influence our choices, because they are just that, our choices. The next steps we take have the potential to be great. So, what does come next? It's such a big question, with an endless possibility of responses. As I look out at this amazing graduating class, I see the infinite answers among us. We are a class off to do new things. We are artists, actors, doctors, engineers, carpenters, athletes, influencers, teachers, and so much more. We are in a golden age of something so good, and I cannot wait to see how we change the world. I am so happy we survived. Here's to what comes next for all of us. Congratulations, class of 2022. We did it. To bring this long letter to a close, I wish you all the best. Hashtag Mofi out.
Two things can be true at the same time. We can be grateful to have reached the culmination of years of our hard work, grateful to be graduating, grateful to soon be taking the first step in chasing our dreams in college, trade school, the military, or the workforce. Yet while we have so many reasons to be grateful, we may simultaneously be angry. Angry that our only completely normal year of high school was our freshman year. Angry that an unforeseen global pandemic ripped away our sophomore and junior year experiences and threw us into circumstances we had never faced before. Angry that despite our desires, our senior year began with our country still engulfed in a war against a virus. When we stepped into school on our first day of high school, none of us ever could have imagined what was in store for us. These 4 years have been anything but easy and predictable. Yet, as we all have come to understand so well, life is neither fair nor constant. However, we have the power to control how we think, feel, and act. Every day when we wake up, we can choose to dwell on that which fuels our anger, or to focus on the things that we do have in life, the things that we have a tendency to take for granted. As the renowned American essayist Ralph Waldo Emerson once said, We must cultivate the habit of being grateful for every good thing that comes to us, and to give thanks continuously. And because all things have contributed to our advancement, we should include all things in our gratitude. If the past few years have taught us anything, it's that we don't have to chase extraordinary moments to find happiness. It's right in front of us if we pay attention and practice gratitude. During the height of the pandemic, when we could not interact with our friends on a daily basis, attend classes in the normal school setting, play the sports we loved, and be involved in the community in the ways we wished to, we were forced to find gratitude in the things we most often forget to be thankful for. The health and well-being of our family, the roof over our head, the food on our table, the opportunity to learn and prosper every day. As we have seen firsthand, everything can change in the blink of an eye. What we have come to expect can easily be turned into a treasured experience. So we must remember, it is our gratitude that separates our privilege from entitlement. The less we feel entitled to, and the more we practice gratitude, the more we're able to celebrate others and find enjoyment in our own lives. When we make the conscious decision to focus on what we have, instead of what we don't have, we open the opportunity for ourselves to an easier relationship with joy. No matter how much we will it so, happiness is not something that is earned, worn, consumed, or owned. It is gratitude that is the gateway to joy. When we take the time to practice gratitude, we unconsciously shield ourselves from negativity, relieve stress, and rewire our brains in a positive way. To have appreciation for what we have been blessed with is the key to dissolving hatred, hurt, and sadness, and is the remedy to restoring self-confidence and respect in our battered states of mind. As much as I would love to say that an attitude of gratitude fixes every blemish in our lives, that simply isn't true. Gratitude doesn't have the ability to change the events in our lives, but it does have the ability to change the way we perceive such events. It gives us resilience and provides us with the strength to fight back in times in which we feel hopeless and out of control. To borrow more words from Emerson, nothing can bring us peace but ourselves. We have little control over the circumstances of our lives, but we do have control over how we choose to react to our given circumstances. We can either succumb to our sadness, resentment, and anger, or bring forth joy born from our refusal to acknowledge the darkness. What happened in the past and what will happen in the future is of little consequence compared to what lies within us. We have had a high school experience that was anything but conventional. But despite the circumstances, we have grown to become admirable young adults, eager to begin the rest of our lives. The struggles born from this pandemic and our individual lives will eventually ebb away like the tide, only for the next wave of challenges to crash over us and throw us back into the sea of turmoil that is this precious gift of life. Yet no matter how much this turmoil will seek to pull us under, it is our gratitude that will always keep us afloat.
Good evening. I want to start off by thanking all the teachers, staff, and administrators who made it possible for us to be here as an entire class. I know that the school district has worked tirelessly to make this night special. Today marks the beginning of the next chapter in our lives, filled with new opportunities, new people, and new memories to be made and held dear. Looking back on these past years at the final page of our collective education, it is often tradition to fixate on all that we've experienced, enjoyed, and embraced. We tend to focus on the ups rather than the downs, the laughs rather than the tears, the cheers instead of the silence. When we recount our experiences for which we are the most grateful, We generally remember the quaint and wholesome memories that we cherish in our hearts, not the moments that left us dejected or the challenges that we struggled to overcome. Nevertheless, it is essential to recognize all that we have experienced, instead of discriminating between the value of the good and the bad. Our unfortunate experiences, a friendship gone awry, a bad grade, a canceled trip, or even a messy breakup, teach us invaluable lessons about our self-worth, our motivation, and the question that we often ask ourselves, who am I, and who do I want to be? These often uncomfortable scenarios teach us more about ourselves than any good memory. They make us confront the messiness of life, who we truly are deep within the superficiality of high school expectations, and for that, we should be thankful. Ralph Waldo Emerson has often grappled with what the concept of gratitude truly means. He believes that because all things have contributed to our advancement in life, we should include all things in our gratitude. Every single moment and version of our past selves has shaped us into the human beings we are today, ready to succeed and conquer the obstacles of the future, ready to embrace new opportunities and excel in situations that we have yet to encounter. Our past hardships, wanted or not, develop strength and resilience within ourselves. It is only fitting, therefore, that we shift our point of view on life as a whole to be more thankful for the adversities that we were all faced with, especially over the past few years. Yet, not all moments of our lives can be reduced to the simple descriptions of good and bad. What about those moments that seem to have no significance, no magnitude, no gravity in our lives? Those memories that seem too trivial to even bother noting in our limited recollections. Being thankful for every mundane event in our lives may seem futile and unachievable in the long run. However, if we put in an effort to change our perspective on the world around us, to look for what is good, what can be good, over time, we'll realize that being grateful has become second nature. People see only what they want to see, what they are ready to see. So I hope that we can collectively train our minds to see the miraculousness of the daily, of the ordinary, of the common. We can learn to appreciate the moments that seem to pass us by, whether it be a time of laughter, of boredom, or of wonder. I believe that we can all appreciate, especially at this very moment, that time is not an endless, tangible thing. Rather, it slips out of our hands faster and faster each minute, day, and year. I believe that often we do not truly recognize the importance of certain moments until those moments cease to exist. We take repetitive, everyday tasks for granted until they're taken away and we mourn their loss. I'm sure we all miss those simple moments in school when we were forced to go online over 2 years ago. A silly question never asked, since it was too much stress to turn on the mic in the midst of a dead silent Zoom. A joke never cracked, since laughter is a tough response to expect from a faceless, voiceless audience. A salty snack never enjoyed, since the movie was being streamed and the glitchy visuals and the delayed audio took away the fun of it. The first snow never collectively observed, since for some reason it wasn't as special anymore, watching it through a window all alone. All of these simple pleasures were lost to us. But, that being said, I hope that those moments, or lack thereof, taught us that we shouldn't undervalue seemingly dull and monotonous events in our lives. We should feel thankful for the simple hellos and the quiet giggles, the apprehensive questions and the crunchy popcorn, the first snowfall and the punny dad joke. Because, all things considered, life takes place in those unremarkable moments, not the once-in-a-lifetime events that mark only a singular instant of our existence. Regardless, it is never too late to recognize the importance of the fleeting memories and to start giving gratitude. It is never too late to choose kindness and appreciation over indifference and jealousy. Rather than yearning for what we were not able to attain, what we do not currently have, or what we will never get a chance to experience, or rather than mourn for memories never made, I wish that we can delight in the absoluteness of the concrete present. I hope we can all awake each morning with devoutness for the loving people, both old and new, who surround us, and the simple, ordinary events of each day that remind us of our collective humanity. Each version of ourselves throughout our entire academic walks of life have made us the people we are today. I encourage you to never lose sight of that fact, to remember that we learn and grow as a result of our struggles, and that regret is a foul-tasting emotion. It is bittersweet, really, the duality of life, how inseparable our past is between the good and the bad, the joyous and the miserable, the unremarkable and the marvelous, the chaotic and the peaceful. But I think that the beauty of life stems from that duplexity. It is with a lens of wonder and ceaseless gratitude that I regard my own memories at Hershey High School and the future before me. And I utterly wish that you choose to share that lens to view your own life alongside me. Thank you.
Thank you to the members of our Hershey High School choir joining us this evening for that beautiful performance. Bravo. Good evening, everyone, and welcome. Hola y bienvenidos. Bonjour. Ni hao. Konnichiwa. Assalamu alaikum. Namaste. And shalom. My name is Lindsay Schmidt, and I am the principal at Hershey High School. First of all, I would like to say that I am very honored to have been given the opportunity to present this speech to our distinguished graduates and their loved ones. No matter where you're watching from, thank you for being here. Your presence is indicative of the role you've played in a graduating senior's educational experience. Thank you to everyone who is a part of our school, our teachers, support staff, parents, families, and friends. Thank you to our supportive administrative staff, especially Dr. Stacy Winslow, Dr. Aaron Schumann, Dr. Jason Reifsnyder, Ms. Lori Wade, Mr. Michael Montedoro, and the Derry Township Board of School Directors. The graduates before you are a product of your unwavering support and unconditional love. They are the products of all of us, no matter how great or how small our interactions were. Let us now think about tradition reimagined. Graduates, Hershey has a rich, deep tradition of principles and values. While we have shaped them, nurtured them, and imagined them during your schooling, now it is your time to reimagine your traditions. Those traditions have been given to you by Hershey High School, Derry Township School District, your community, your families, and your heritage. Now is the time to build on what you've become over the last 13 or so years. You can reinvent it. You can redesign it. You can certainly upgrade it. You can be you 2.0. And you can leave these new, even better traditions with everyone you meet. This is your legacy. You may have heard Rita Pearson's TED Talk entitled, Every Kid Needs a Champion. Rita Pearson also said this, and it came to mind when preparing for this commencement. She said, I am somebody. I was somebody when I came. I will be a better somebody when I leave. I am powerful and I am strong. I deserve the education that I get here. I have things to do, people to impress, and places to go. You were certainly all somebody when you arrived, whether it was in kindergarten at the ECC, or whether it was just sometime this school year, or sometime in between. No matter how long you've been with us in Hershey, you are somebody. You're somebody who has been influenced by the people you've met, the experiences you've endured, and the education you've embraced. The somebody you choose to leave the Giant Center as is up to you. How will you reimagine what traditions you've been given? Because, like Pearson said, you're powerful, strong, and educated. What will you do with these traits? Who will you impress? Where will you go? Only you can imagine. Of course, this means we will have up to 290 very different somebodies who graduate tonight. Because what drives us, shapes us, and inspires us is uniquely different for every individual. Whether your family says, hola, namaste, shalom, or something else entirely, we can go back to Rita Pearson. You're powerful, strong, and educated. You have so much to do. My call to action for you is this. Everyone becomes a different somebody. These differences are shaped by our personal experiences, relationships, and our choices. To all of the different and unique somebodies, embrace them. To all, extend grace and kindness to them without reservation. A great African proverb reads, "The child who is not embraced by the village will burn it down to feel its warmth." It is your village now. How will you reimagine your own traditions to foster this village and the somebody who you will become? Thank you again so much for being here to support the class of 2022. And congratulations to the graduates sitting before me. You did it. We now welcome to the podium Dr. Stacy Winslow, Superintendent of Schools.
Good evening, graduates, families. This is the most normal graduation we've had for over 2 years, and it's fabulous to see you all here like this, to see so many people in the crowds, and I am humbled and honored to be here with you tonight. I wanted to leave you with a short quote from Steve Jobs. Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else is secondary. You are truly the next leaders in our world. And I know that there are wonderful things ahead of you. And without further ado, Ms. Schmidt, on behalf of the Derry Township School Board, it is my great privilege to accept the class of 2022 at this year's commencement and confer upon them the right to a Hershey High School diploma. By the authority granted to me by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I publicly declare that the Hershey High School seniors before us are deserving of a Hershey High School diploma, signifying that they have satisfied the academic and attendance requirements of the Derry Township School District and the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the class of 2022.
Mofifoluwa Oladipo, Marissa Jean Kopec, Ece Aydogan, Hajar Abdullah, Adina Abdich, Matthew Abraham, Zachariah Ahmad, Paria Akram, Marco Alicandri, Isabella Amato, Noah Amato, Samantha Andrews, Alec Angelo, Jack Argento, Benjamin Richard Babbitt, Daniel Boschnick, Alec Bai, Brent Michael Bailey, Ava Baker, Allison Balcom, Matthew Bali, Deanna Banks, Jada Banks, Katie Louise Barrett, Layla May Barros, Angelo Becerra, Sophia Beck. Allison Beitzel. Alexis Bell. Jaquan Barrier. Aiden Robert Bertoldi. Mia Bertoldi. Brendan Betts. Amanda Lee Bishop. Alex Blacker. Elizabeth Julia Begret. William Bonafont. Shane Lewis Brace. Alexandria Brown. Kara Elizabeth Brown. Mackenzie Brown. Zachary Brown. Taylor Burkholder. Garrett Burries. Connor Kane. Ayla Rayanne Campos. Matthew Carrera. Andrea Elise Carroll. Elijah Case. Xander James Castillo. Hannah Catalone. Anna Chapel. Colin Clough. Andrew F. Coleman. Audrey Jo Confer. Cam Cooney. Ethan Cooper. Catherine Louise Copper. Mary Lydia Cotter. Anna Coulter. Bridget Cox. Aaron Riley Cray. Lauren Cribbs. Samuel Dawson. Maria de la Paz Gonzalez. Alan John Dexheimer. Melina DeTall. Caroline Deem. Taryn Marie Danello. Kevin Ding. Kylie Dixon. Martin Victor Dachulian. Emily Grace Donegan. Aaron Lee Dreyer. Sarah Megan Dreyer. Noah Christopher Drexler. Eunice Khan Durrani. Amelia Elaine Dye. Madison Ebert. Guy M. Emmerich. Jaden Michael Engel. Jackson Patrick Farman. Isabel Fasick. Ashley Faust. Ella Ferns. Samuel Fickus. McKenna Jewel Fickett. Tanner Fields. Ashlyn Fish. Kiva Fitterer, Deirdre Fitzsimons, Liam Daniel Flynn, Lillian Fountain, Mirko Gaeta, Maggie Gagliano, Helen Elizabeth McKinney Gavazzi, Mallory Gillespie, Hayden Tanner Gilmore, Hunter Gilmore, Diana Glant, Caroline Gluss, Summer Elizabeth Grafe, David Green, Julia L. Grenoble, Michaela Rose Grocott, Dario Arturo Guillen, Caitlin Guzman, Elisa Habecker, Allison Hahn, Shayla Marie Hassler, Landon Heisey, Rhiannon Michaela Hind, Daniel Hogan, Benjamin William Gannon Hole, Claire Gannon Hole, Caitlin Hoover, Luke Hoover, Charles Horner, Annika Hosenfeld, Harley Hool, Sophia Howe, Jack Hulse, Hunter Himes, Kelsey Itwaru, Malcolm Jenkins, Rodrigo Jimenez, Lily Cockle, Antonio Andreas Carantonis, Arav Castoria, Toby Glenn Kaufman, Zachariah Harbush, Sophia Kim. Zachary Knoll, Samantha Autumn Kegler, Rain Kalangian, Alexander Crum, Aiden Dreg LeMay Timmons, Maggie LaWall, Brooke Layerman, Alexa Langle, Alexander Lynn. Shan Lynn. Karen Liu. Cadence Logan. Drew McNear, Brianna McMullen, Darius Makua, Tony Maldonado, Adriana Malena, Hannah Mara, Evan Marshall, James Marcini, Nicholas J. Martin, Scott Turley Mason, India Mays, D'Angelo Mayfield, Lysandra MacArthur, Luke Andrew McCorkle, Matthew McCurdy, Ryan Michelson. Nicholas Miles. Sean Miles. Zachary Moreland Miller. Bryce Matthew Mills. Nicholas Moniak. Courtney Moody. Melissa Moore. Kaylee Marrera. Trinity Morrison. Elizabeth Murray. Ben Musanti. Moise Nasser. Ashley Nichols. Adam Nielsen. Nathan Nielsen. Tyler Nielsen. Catherine Nutt. Mojala Olua. Emmanuel Olietti. Dylan O'Shell. Sami Aaron Ozdoan. Tyson Painter. Cassandra Paoletti. Harry Paniagua. Emily Rose Parker. Kushi Patel. Jack Paterno. Tommy Paul. Emma Pavone. Gage Pinkowski. Bresnet Perez Serrano. Jordan Perlikowski. Lauren Postupak. Irina Elizabeth Patachny. Leah Powers. Andrew Randall. Lauren Marie Reed. Jenna Reiber. Madison Reed. Maeve Sophia Ryder. Luke Edward Remig. Shamir Riar. Bella Rapon. Anna Rogers. Cameron Rodriguez. Justin Rogers. Julius Lino Rosa. Sean Walker Roland. Jaden Ruiz. Emma Russell. Colby Sanders. Connor James Saunders. Jonathan Saunders. Aisha Savadago. Owen Schmidt. Alex Scorza. Nicholas Josue Scorza. Julius Ramos Semple. Julia. Andrew Settles. Ayush Sharma. Islam Shavkatov. Caitlin Sheehan. Micah Shepherd. Molly Sherma. Finian Carney Sig. Tayem Marie Annalise Sims. Sharanpreet Singh. Madeline Amariah Smith. Maxwell Snyder. Olivia Marie Spokart. Sophia Diana Stalebrink. Jameson Stanley. Kirsten Starner. Noah Steinley. Trent Steller. Hunter Stevens. Joseph Still. Miriam Stinson. Owen Strader. Maurice Swanson. Luke Joseph Zacharash. Shariah Sharit Cardona Tafour. Sonia Tamang. Maggie Tarkenton. Christopher Michael Taylor. Emma Taylor. Jacob Taylor. Catherine Tuchin. Anthony A. Tamino. Peter Verbeek. Ayush Verma. Daniel Voigt Jr. Melissa Voiles. John Russell Wallace. Amy Walmer. Aaron Walter. Lisa Wong. Mason Weber. Damaria Victoria Delcy Wedderburn. Brock West. Still have more. Angela Lee White. Emma Elizabeth May Wildeson. Sean Williams. Cameron Matthew Willis. Carter Wisneski. Hayden Parker Woodburn. Kyrie Wright. Shan Wu. Adley Yang. Shanxi Yang. Maya Yashinsky. Hannah Yoder. Abby Yurick. Elizabeth Grace Zachary. Adam E. Zagul. Julia Zakovich. Chandler Zhang. Lydia Zarifas. Andrew Zhao. Ben Zimmer. Grantham Zimmerman. Sam Zuckerman. Ladies and gentlemen, Hershey High School's class of 2022.